Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. This is the video today on the Knipex Pliers Wench. That's what these are called. The Pliers Wench. And that's obvious in the way they're sort of designed, as they've got a head here that is like a wrench or a spanner, as we call them in the UK. A really handy tool, these. I really like these. It sort of takes the necessity away from needing a full set of spanners at your workbench. Or, I mean, obviously it'll never take away the necessity for having a set of spanners, because things like combination spanners and open-ended spanners have specific functions. But you get the drift. What I mean is, if you have these on the side of the bench, they'll definitely come in handy. Say you've got a set of, well, for instance, like me, you have all your spanners somewhere else. If you keep a set of these handy, it saves you traipsing round to the garage all the time, you know, to get a specific spanner when this one will actually fit. It's sort of like a set of mole grips, but it's a spanner that will fit anything up to the specified size. Now, these are the 180mm versions, which means that the length of the tool is 180mm long, which is denoted by the way Knipex do their part numbers. We've got an 86 model number on there. I believe that's what that is. It's the model number of the tool. The 05 is to do with the way the handles are designed, which is, these are the dual component handles, which are, I find, comfier to use. And they also do an 03 model, which is the sort of dipped plastic handle, you know, the plain plastic handle like you get on ordinary pump pliers. I find them a bit, sometimes they can get a bit slippy as well when using them, and these have like a texture to them, so I find these always nicer to hold. So yeah, as I said, these are sort of like mole grips, because you've got in one tool, you've got basically a spanner head that will go from, let's see, will actually go from 0mm. Now, obviously, you're not going to have a 0mm nut or a bolt, but it will go all the way off from 0 to 30. I think the maximum limit is 35mm for these particular ones. Now, they do actually do a 150mm version, which it's 150mm in length. I chose these because these would be more suitable for my hand size. I just thought this would be the best size to get. These are the middle ones. As I say, they do a 150, a 180, and they also do a 250mm version, which are obviously going to be 120mm longer than these, so that's quite a bit bigger. And for sort of electronics and, you know, general use, these are probably, you know, a perfect size. And also, you know, with a a spanner head that goes up to, you know, 35mm, there's not much in, I don't know whether there's anything in electronics really that goes up to that sort of size. I mean, I got this out just for a, you know, sort of to show you how it gripped on, and what it would sort of be needed for. Like, I didn't actually notice this when I got these out, but we've got another nut there, and they've got a nice narrowish head. When you think of a spanner head, you think of a 35mm spanner head, is probably just as wide, if not wider than that. Obviously, because, you know, a 35mm spanner is going to obviously be undoing and tightening 35mm nuts or bolts, which will probably need quite a bit of force to loosen and tighten. So they've got to have a substantial sort of design. The way these are designed are basically like pump pliers again, where they've got, remember the ones I did the other day, the reviewer did the other day on these ones, very similar, slightly different pitch on the threads there, but obviously designed for this particular tool. They can be put anywhere along that rail. Basically, this is just it's like a one piece tool there with a handle thrown on the other side. Well, it's a three piece tool actually, but it's a one piece main body of the tool with a handle thrown on there, a rivet put in, and then an adjustable sliding part of the wrench on that end, which gives it all its movement. Because in there you've just got two sort of lobes that grip on or sort of interleave with that head and give it, you know, a little bit of movement on you know, on its this axis or this rail, if you like. What I do like about them is that it's not with a spanner, you've got a specific size. For instance, say this nut, I don't know what size this is, it looks like an 11 or 12 mil, so you would automatically get an 11 or 12 mil spanner. So you go down to your toolbox or whatever, or wherever your toolbox is, get 11 mil spanner, you come back up and you find out it's actually 12 mil, so you have to go back to your tool, well, you know what I mean, you go down, you probably get a handful of spanners that are within a range, but with this, you don't need to do that, you just grab one of these, and you know, whatever size the nut is, you've got the tool for the job, because you've got a little bit of, you know, well, you've got quite a lot of movement to either side. You can also grab on, you know, like that, so you've got quite a wide opening in the plier there, you know, for if, you know, if you really want to grip that nut tight. Now that's virtually locked on. Well, you know, I can pick that motor up, that's a big motor, you know, and pick that up with the grip it's actually got on that nut. So there's no way. See, I was thinking before I bought these and had a quick glance at them, I thought they're not going to be much good. You know, you've got a lot of movement here, so if you go, you know, click on like that and you put it on a nut, these are just going to force open, and you know, you're going to round a load of nuts off, especially when they're tight. But obviously, by the way it's been designed, they lock on really tight. I mean, you can go to the, I think it's the next step down, and obviously you can see the handles are closer together there. Now that's still got a pretty good grip. I've still got hold of that properly. That motor must weigh, I don't know, £3, £4. So you can see how you know, what sort of grip it's got on it. There's no way that nut is going to spin in there, even if it's got a bolt going through it and it's really tight on the thread. Same for this, same set of pliers, obviously. You know, just, you know, gauge what sort of size nut you've got, what bolt you've got, and just fit him on like that. And you've got hold of, I don't know, it's a bit thin that one, but you can see I've still got hold of it, no problem at all. I can undo these, have never been undone by the way, so it's a good test. That's actually undoing, I don't know, I've got a nut on the other side, you can see there, so I would need you know, a combi spanner to go on the back of there. But you can see that's really tight, and that's undoing, no problem at all, you know. So that's the sort of area where, you know, these would come into their own. Also in tight spaces, that's quite a, I know it's not a super confined space, but say you needed to get to that nut, just adjust your pliers to about the right size, you know, see that you've got it, and there you go, just open, that's how quick it is, you know, to undo a nut. I'm not even clamping these hard, there's just no need to do it, you just don't need much force at all. And as you can see by the nut, you know, there's no rounding, you know, the nut's perfectly okay. Whereas, you know, you might think, you know, without one of these, you'd be thinking to yourself, oh, you know, stick a pair of pliers on one end, set of mole grips on the other end, you know, and it'll be done. But you'll end up with the sheet, you know, the rounded off nuts and bolts. Same way if you have to use them on a tiny little nut. This is on, I think this is out of a Kenwood food mixer, I believe, this motor. I just had it lying round just to show you on the video. You've got little tiny nuts there, which are undoing no problem. It's probably got a screw spinning on the other side, but you know, you get the idea. And that's, you know, quite a confined space. You would need an open-ended spanner for that. I'm not sure whether a, you know, a combi spanner or a ring spanner would go around there because of the tapered, the angled body of the motor. So yeah, a great tool. If you've got, I think, £25, £30 to spare, or, you know, you're thinking of something perhaps to get for Christmas, I can thoroughly advise those, and they'll probably come in handy for anybody who's doing, I don't know, electronics, mechanics, plumbing, anything. Yeah, so, hope you liked that video, guys. I'll speak to you soon. Take care.